Hi everyone. So in this video, we're going to have a look at how to transfer data from an Arduino to a NodeMCU via the serial port or the serial line. Now this sort of approach would be useful if you had multiple sensors connected to your Arduino and you wanted to transfer that data to the NodeMCU and thereby push the data onto the cloud or push it online. So without waiting any longer, let's get right into it. Now, if you guys like this video, don't forget to give me a thumbs up by clicking the like button below. And if you haven't done so already, please subscribe. I'm Chums, and welcome to That's Engineering. Right, so there are multiple methods that can be used to transfer data from one device to another. For example, I2C or serial communication, which in my opinion is one of the easiest and most convenient methods, and it is what we will be looking at in this video. So for demonstration purposes, I will be using a DHT11 temperature and humidity sensor. Now this is solely for the purpose of collecting some sensor data so that it can be transferred from the Arduino to the NodeMCU. So let's have a look at the flow of data. So we would start by collecting our sensor readings via our Arduino and placing that data on the serial port. This will then be sent to the NodeMCU. And from the NodeMCU, that data can be pushed online or to the cloud via the ESP12 Wi-Fi module housed inside the NodeMCU. This can also work in reverse, where you can pull data from the cloud to the NodeMCU and then place that data on the serial port and send it back to the Arduino for some sort of actuation of any device. Now, this sort of concept or methodology would be most useful if you were implementing an IoT or a cloud connect based system or following something regarding Industry 4.0. So before we get on to the physical connections and looking at the code, let's have a very quick look at the overall connections between our three devices. So first of all three devices have to have a common ground. They have to be grounded to each other. For the DHT11, one pin, which is the VCC, will be connected to +5 volts of the Arduino, and the data pin or the out pin will be connected to any data pin on the Arduino. I usually use pin number 4. And you will see this reflected when discussing the code. Now the important part is the connection between the Arduino and the NodeMCU. So because this is a serial connection, we would have two data connections. One would be receiving RX and one would be for transmitting TX. Now most people would use the RX and TX ports on the Arduino and NodeMCU respectively, but I think it's easier to just use any two PWM ports on the Arduino and their respective NodeMCU ports. So I used pin 5 on the Arduino connected to pin D5 on the NodeMCU, followed by pin 6 on the Arduino connected to pin D6 on the NodeMCU. Now these pins have to be assigned as receiving RX and transmitting TX pins. How you want to assign them is up to you, but what you should remember is that they should be opposite for the NodeMCU and Arduino. What I mean by this is that if pin 5 is assigned as RX on the Arduino, then it should be assigned as TX on the NodeMCU and vice versa. This is because when the NodeMCU is transmitting, the Arduino has to receive, and when that's transmitting, the NodeMCU has to receive. It doesn't really matter when you're making the physical connections, but you have to keep this in mind when writing the code. Right, so now let's have a look at the physical connections. The components you will need are a bunch of connecting wires, the DHT11 temperature and humidity sensor, an Arduino Uno, and the NodeMCU.
Right, so the NodeMCU is not breadboard friendly. What that means is you cannot directly fix it onto a single breadboard. Instead, you can buy a holder, which would be the more practical or professional thing to do. I, however, don't have that. So what I've done is I've connected half of it to one breadboard and the other half to another breadboard. Right, so let's go ahead and wire up the connections. Now, we'll take positive 5 volts from the Arduino and connect it to a common pin. And I'm going to ground the Arduino to the next pin. So that's going to be the common ground. I've already grounded the NodeMCU to the common ground. Right, so for the software serial connection, I will be using pins 5 and 6. So pin number 5 from the Arduino will go to pin D5 on the NodeMCU. And pin 6 on the Arduino will go to pin D6 on the NodeMCU. Oops. Right. The final thing is to wire up the DHT11 sensor. So the cornermost pin will go to ground, the common ground. The VCC will go to plus 5 volts. And the data pin will go to pin number 4 on the Arduino. You're free to use whatever data pin you like. I'll be using pin 4. Right, so those are the physical connections.
Right, so now let's have a look at the code. Two programs are written, one for the Arduino and one for the NodeMCU, as they are both separate programming boards. Now I will leave a link in the description down below where you can access these codes, so do have a look at that. So I started off by including the DHT library. Now this is for the Arduino side code. I then included the library for software serial to enable serial communication between the two devices. I also included the Arduino JSON library. This was to create a JSON object which would store the sensor readings being transferred from one device to the other. So to obtain this library, go to Tools, Manage Libraries, and search for JSON. Right, and you would obtain this sort of library, Arduino JSON by Benoit Blanchon. I hope I'm pronouncing his name correctly. So go ahead and install this library. I've already installed it. Right, I then enabled the serial connection by specifying the RX and TX ports on the Arduino side. So pin 5 for RX, pin 6 for TX. This bit of code initializes the DHT11 sensor. It was connected to pin 4 and two variables were allocated for temperature and humidity. Under the loop, I created a static JSON buffer. So you can create a static or a dynamic buffer. If you create a static buffer, it has a predefined size which I set to be 1000. So based on that, I created a JSON object using the attribute create object and I named it data. So this JSON object is what will store the sensor readings as different values within the object. I then ran a function to obtain the sensor readings. So this function is down here. Simply, I obtained humidity and temperature using the read humidity and read temperature attributes and printed it on the serial monitor. So once the humidity and temperature readings were obtained, they were assigned to the JSON object in this format. Next, the JSON object was placed on the serial line using the print2 command or print2 attribute, and the JSON buffer was then cleared to create space to allow for the next set of humidity and temperature readings. So that's the Arduino code. Now let's have a look at the NodeMCU code. Right, so this is the code for the NodeMCU. Similarly, it also has the software serial library and the Arduino JSON library. In this case, the software serial has to be initialized with D6 being the receiving pin RX and D5 being the transmitting pin TX. In the loop, a second static JSON buffer was created, and instead of creating a new JSON object, the object placed on the serial port by the Arduino was parsed or read by the NodeMCU using the parse object command. I use the same naming data to avoid any confusion. I then had a small if function. So it checks to see if the JSON object is valid or invalid. If it's invalid, which means either the temperature and humidity readings have not been sent or they have not been sent correctly, it would print it to the serial monitor, it would clear the JSON buffer and return to the beginning of the loop. So this would continue until a valid set of readings are obtained. Given a valid set of readings are obtained, it would jump to this command where it would print that the JSON object has been received and then go ahead and print the humidity and temperature on the serial monitor. So you can simply obtain the readings using this sort of a command. You have to allocate a variable and read the attribute of the JSON object data. So in this case, it's humidity, and in this case, it's temperature. So that's the code. Let's go ahead and run it and see how it works. Right, so now let's see how this code runs. I have already uploaded the code, but before you upload it, make sure to check what your board is. Make sure that the correct Arduino board is selected and check your COM port. So for me, the Arduino is on COM3 and the NodeMCU is on COM4. Right, so I've already uploaded the Arduino code. So if I go to the serial monitor, I can see the temperature and humidity readings coming every 2 seconds. So this is on the Arduino. Now these readings have to be put into the JSON object and sent to the NodeMCU via the serial port. So let's go ahead and close this. Right, so this is the code for the NodeMCU. Now again, I have already uploaded the code, but before you upload it, make sure that your board is selected to NodeMCU. So you can do that by actually scrolling down and you can find NodeMCU over here. Make sure your upload speed is at this particular value over here and the correct COM port is selected. So my NodeMCU is on COM4. I've already uploaded the code, so let's go ahead and look at the serial monitor. Right, so the JSON object is received and the received humidity and the received temperature is as such. And this will keep going every 2 seconds as long as the Arduino is sending that particular JSON object with the data inside it. Alright everyone, so that's all for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed it and learned something. Now if you guys have any questions or clarifications on the work we just did, please feel free to leave a comment and I will do my best to get back to you. If you guys like this video, don't forget to give me a thumbs up by clicking the like button below, and if you haven't done so already, please click that subscribe button. Thank you all for watching, stay safe, and I'll see you in the next video.